One second. Will it work? Swapan Das Gupta.
I don't know. It depends on the quality of the response. But I think the most important here issue which people are asking is what is the extent of the personal culpability of the Prime Minister. Now, if the Prime Minister is able to convince people that he has no personal culpability in the whole matter, it may be diffused. But at the same time, by doing so, he will say that this was a total failure of his government. At present, what they are trying to do is saying, no, it wasn't the failure of the government. It was the fault of Naveen Patnaik. Now, that is an astonishing piece of sophistry, which is very difficult for people to swallow. And at the Prime Minister, it seems to me, is more or less a prisoner in the hands of the vocal and belligerent and at times lumpen section of his own party. This Prime Minister has never had a voice, and today his voicelessness, if that's a word that can be used,
Renuka Chaudhary, costing
him personally. It's going to cost him personally because it's his personal integrity. In the 2G scandal, he was accused of looking the other way while others looted the exchequer. Here today, he's being accused of actually sitting idly while the people in his own office, his own department, perpetuated a wrong for 8 solid years.
Change of strategy required, Renuka Chaudhary, now? Because this whole argument that our Prime Minister can do no wrong doesn't seem to quite be working. At least not among the opposition leaders.
It's not about whether it works or not, doesn't work. The fact of the matter is that the gentleman concerned is a very decent man, perhaps too decent for India's politics and for media debates. It's unfortunate that, you know, niceness is...
And for India's politicians.
Absolute integrity is viewed because he's not jumping in front of TV and saying things and performing for the benefit of television audience or the parliament. What more can we say when we are saying we are willing to come to parliament? We are going to discuss it in parliament. We will answer everything. And that is a natural progress. And if after all of that they want the Prime Minister, they are entitled to call for the Prime Minister. Why would they abdicate all of that and go onto the streets and start jumping up and down? I don't understand that.
Mr. Rudy.
And then blaming the Prime Minister without even hearing the facts, without even knowing what happened. And I can say with absolute belief, with God as my witness, I know that the Prime Minister has no personal... prove his personal integrity.
No, that is fine, but he was the Minister for Coal.
But someone did. You know, Renuka, someone benefited. If it is not the Prime Minister, let us know. Who did this cronyism benefit? How did
Where
this
you want us to tell
use
you
of discretionary parts?
Who did it benefit? You at India Gate. We are willing to tell you this in Parliament. Let Parliament function. We'll come there and tell you. Where do you want us to tell at Ramlila
Ground? Why doesn't your CBI find out?
We are not Anna Hazare's. We will tell you in Parliament.
Come to Parliament, let Parliament function.
We will tell you.
You'll allow a voting machine?
There is inquiries going on. Their mines, the coal blocks,
he has never told anyone anything.
One second.
He has governed in silence.
One second. Rajiv Rudy raised his hand. He has a right to rebut. Rajiv Rudy, you'll agree to a voting motion.
Yes.
I'm trying to see if there's some ground here. Otherwise, are we going to see tomorrow also? 11 o'clock, another locked session. 2 o'clock, locked.
Just a second.
What's the bet?
I don't know. I'm asking. Rajiv Rudy is rebutting you. Renuka Chaudhary. Yes. Rudy.
Just assume that there are three constitutional bodies involved here. One is the CAG, there is another constitutional body called the CBC as well. Now let's forget for a while that there was no report given by the CAG. But meanwhile, the Central Vigilance Commissioner has handed over a case to the CBI And now a CAG report also comes saying that there is an involvement of the coal ministry, which was headed by the Prime Minister. Do you suggest, with the Prime Minister speaking in Parliament and continuing in that position, that the impartiality of the probe of the CBI, can it ever happen in this country? And for the sake of
let
what
me,
the man is for now is the Prime Minister. Is it justified for him to continue that? Let's forget.
No, Rajiv Rudy.
I'm asking you what.
To continue that?
Rajiv Rudy. Do we go by the principle?
Mr. Rudy.
Do we go by the principle?
Rajiv Rudy, 1 minute. Rajiv Rudy, 1 minute. You're getting a rebut from Krishna Prasad. I have a few minutes left. Do we go by the principle or not? Till
when,
now,
when it happens, sir, when it happens with the 2G, he says it is Raja. When it happens in the Commonwealth, he says it is Suresh Kalmadi.
Yes.
When it happens now in the CAG with the coal blocks, it says it
yes.
is.
Yes. No. There's a difference with 2G. There's a difference with 2G.
It's the Prime Minister, boss.
No. There's a difference with 2G. One second. While I'm not being
forgiven. Now you are trying to give him a clean chit. No. This is
no. One second. One minute, Rajiv.
He's been caught.
Rajiv, give me a second then, please.
He can't escape.
Now I know that you have taken over as the anchor.
We are going to stall Parliament because this
now I know that you have taken over.
Party realizes.
You have your.
This
your,
is the only way this government realizes.
Now you have. Now you have truly.
The dock and the government and the country is not going to get.
Rajiv Rudy, your self-confessed secret urge to be the anchor of the news hour, you've actually taken over in the last 30 seconds. I want to tell you something. I want to tell you something. I want to point out to you. You see, there's a difference with 2G. In 2G, A. Raja twisted rules to benefit certain companies. I'm not arguing for the Prime Minister. And also, there is a question of proving criminal intent. So, you can ask for the Prime Minister's resignation if you prove criminal intent. In that case, this has not happened here. Mr. Arun Jaitley is one of the country's best-known lawyers. He wouldn't argue that case if he wants to argue from the other side. But Mr. Arun Jaitley is arguing from one side today. So I want to give Krishna Prasad, who wanted to come in, a point that he wanted to make. Krishna was responding to you briefly, gentlemen. This is an interesting debate, but yes. Krishna, briefly, please.
You know, Arnav, I just want to make a very short point. I mean, how many institutions will the BJP not trust? You cannot trust Parliament, you cannot trust JPC, how many institutions will you not trust? I mean, you need to start somewhere. I mean, it's one thing to say that the Prime Minister, you know, is got a question mark over his head, but to talk of a clean chit, etc., is a little too premature. You know, I do think the BJP is well within its right to ask these questions, but there's a way, there's a forum, and there's a manner in which to be asked. To constantly you know, chip away at our institutions, a very dangerous path to go on. Eventually we'll be left with nothing, frankly, at the end of the day.
No, well, that's a point, but you know, Parliament requires a debate, even if it means sometimes questioning the institutions. Yesterday when we asked why Rajiv Rudy was whispering to the Deputy Chairman of the House, Somnath Chatterjee, Rajiv Shukla. Rajiv Shukla. Thank you, Rajiv. Rajiv Shukla was whispering to the Deputy Chairman. Somnath Chatterjee told us, look here, the media is taking on the last institution. It's destroying the credibility of Parliament. That doesn't mean the questions won't be asked. Mr. Mehboob Beg, you have a way out for the Congress party? You think they should offer some midway compromise now instead of taking a hard line?
No, side should take a hard line. If you take a hard line, you will reach nowhere. You have to take a middle path. And the middle path, as he said, a middle path is you have to allow these institutions to function. You have to know and believe these institutions. The only thing you have for the last six decades now, you have built some institutions. Kindly don't destroy those institutions. There is a way in doing everything. There are set procedures. Please follow those procedures and don't bypass those procedures. That's what I was telling you. We are losing credibility because we are not taking the biggest menace, the biggest evil, which is halting and stalling your progress ahead, which is corruption. Because we are only arguing and trying to save and protect our side of it. You have to take this menace head on. Unless you take a middle path and start trusting these well-established institutions, we will not go anywhere.
We have had 2 days of complete stalling. Let's see what happens tomorrow. As of now, I see no possibility of a middle ground. If it happens tomorrow afternoon, it will be the day's biggest political miracle. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for joining me on
the middle ground.
I don't know, ma'am.
What is the middle ground?
I don't know.
They are saying come to parliament.
Maybe a voting motion. Maybe a voting motion.
Is there any other way? We are saying come to parliament, we'll talk.
A middle ground is where you make one step forward and they take a step towards you.
Well, I'm waiting for that. We'll see what happens tomorrow, and we hope there's a resolution, because that's a debate we have promised to cover minute to minute from beginning to end here on Times Now, if it happens.
Certain things for the institution, let speaker decide what to do, how to go about this issue.
Absolutely. Let's wait for that. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining me.